I've heard it said you can't reach the iPod generation with 8-track ministry. Well, that is the wisdom behind a relatively new Bible app called the Parallel Bible. It allows readers to engage the scripture and each other with words and pictures. The creator has many plans for this technology, and he's sitting down with us in Studio 5 to show you how to help him spread the gospel. American missionary and street artist Andrew Brittenberg spent 7 years in poor South African villages, sharing his talent for painting murals.
The idea was to go and work with somebody who's living there to paint their own wall. The idea of bringing color to an otherwise almost completely sort of gray and brown atmosphere was really exciting to them. So that's where it started, because they have a rich faith and they would be always quoting Bible verses to me and saying, like, this is, you know, the hope that I have. And I thought, well, we should just write that on your wall. Mm-hmm. And so we ended up putting scripture in huge, like, you know, 4-foot letters, you know, sometimes, like, right on the highway or, you know, wherever it was. Suddenly this scripture was taking a whole new life. You know, every time someone passed by and read it, they were suddenly sort of experiencing the Bible coming over them in a new way. And that's where I suddenly realized that I felt my life's work would be about finding new ways to present the scriptures.
The first new way is the Parallel Bible app. You could say it's the Bible, art, and social networking all rolled into one.
You create an account and you follow your friends and you post pictures. And it works like Facebook or Instagram that way. Mm-hmm. But what you're also able to do is tag a Bible verse. So all of the images that are coming in on your feed are full of scripture. So it's kind of a way to read the Bible and see life application of the Bible right alongside of it.
Where did that come from?
I found that in the conversations I was having with people about my faith, it would get real dicey around the time when I introduced the Bible into the conversation. So people are willing to talk about spirituality, Jesus even, but when you get to, hey, a lot of this is in this book, I got a lot of, like, you know, shut down. Mm-hmm. And that was sort of what drove me to think, we've got to find a new way to invite people into this text.
How important is this work that you're doing?
Yeah, I think that the Bible has a way to offer life, to bring the very words of God to people. So finding a way to bring the Bible into the 21st century and make it relevant to a whole new generation, I feel like, is probably my life's work.
Do you feel called to this?
Oh, yes. Definitely do. I wouldn't really do things that I haven't been called to. I've sort of made the idea of obedience to the voice of God the driving north point in my life. And it's brought me from New York to Amsterdam to Cape Town and back here to Virginia Beach. And, oh yeah, I wouldn't have it any other way.
Obedience pays off. In just months, Andrew's app has thousands of readers posting images and scriptures 1 to 5 times a week. He's now at work bringing the app to life as a physical book. He'll begin with the book of Mark. And how does it work? How do I get to engage in this as a reader?
You can buy a book on the site. Mm-hmm. It's worth saying that the book isn't cheap. It's going to be $60. But we're hoping that people can understand that buying the book is a way of furthering this work that we're doing, trying to bring the Bible into the hands of people that don't have it.
Do you feel this is the first of its kind? Like, this has not been done before?
It is, yeah. It's the first Bible that incorporates social media, and it's the first book that will be community illuminated, let's say it that way. Mm-hmm. All of the imagery is going to come from the community.
And Andrew is looking to raise the funds to finish this project in just the next few days. We have a link to the details at our website, cbnnews.com.